Commissioners, just a reminder, use your raise hand, please. That would be helpful for me if we're want to comment on any particular item. Chris, Sergio's in. Chris is in. I think we have everybody, Jimmy.
Chairman, I believe that is accurate. Commissioner Granados was last on because he has the very last office. It takes a little while to turn all the computers on.
Okay.
But Chairman, when you are ready, we are ready.
All right, Robert, we're ready?
All ready to go.
Okay. All right. At this time, I'll call for a motion to return from recess.
So moved.
Second.
By the Vice Chair, seconded by Freeholder Moudet. Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Commissioner Angela Garrettson?
Yes.
Commissioner Sergio Granados?
Aye.
Commissioner Christopher Hudak?
Aye.
Commissioner Lourdes Leon?
Aye.
Commissioner Kimberly Palmieri Moudet?
Aye.
Commissioner Andrea Sunshine Staten?
Yes.
Chairman Pro Tem Kowalski? Is that a yes, Chairman? Chairman Pro Tem? That is a yes. We'll make sure we work on the audio. And Vice Chair Rebecca Williams?
Aye.
And Chairman Alexander Mirabella?
Aye.
Chair, you have 9 votes in the affirmative.
Okay. Jimmy, let's have somebody help Commissioner Kowalski. In the meantime,
we'll move on
to the approval of communications. May I have a motion to approve the communications?
So moved.
Second. By the Vice Chair, seconded by Freeholder Garrettson. Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly, Chairman. Right. Commissioner Garrettson.
Yes.
Commissioner Granados.
Aye.
Commissioner Hudak.
Aye.
Commissioner Leon. Commissioner Leon.
Yes.
Aye.
Okay. Commissioner Palmieri Moudet.
Aye.
Commissioner Staten?
Yes.
Chairman Pro Tem Kowalski? I heard a yes. And Vice Chair Rebecca Williams?
Aye.
And Chairman Mirabella?
Aye.
Noting Commissioner Kowalski's yes, 2 doors down, you have 9 votes in the affirmative.
All right, Mr. Clerk, thank you. May I have a motion to suspend the rules to allow for the joining of both the public comment on resolutions being offered for adoption and the public comment on any governmental issue that a member of the public may feel is of concern to the residents of Union County as into one public comment section. May I have a motion, please?
So moved.
Moved by the Vice Chair. Second, please.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Staten. Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly, Chairman. Commissioner Garrettson.
Yes.
Commissioner Granados.
Aye.
Commissioner Hudak.
Are you on mute? Yeah.
So to raise your hand.
Aye.
Bottom right, raise hand.
Commissioner.
Aye.
Commissioner Leon.
Aye.
Commissioner Palmieri Moudet.
Aye.
Commissioner Staten.
Yes.
And Commissioner and Chairman Pro Tem Kowalski. That is a yes. Commissioner Vice Chair Williams.
Aye.
And Commissioner Chairman Mirabella.
Aye.
Chairman, that's 9 votes in the affirmative.
All right, thank you, Mr. Clerk. The meeting is now open to the public. For anyone to wish to speak on resolutions being offered for adoption or any other matter, I'll move it to Jimmy to see if anybody is in the queue for that or anybody submitted comments previously.
Chairman, I did not receive any comments via email to be read into the record. We do have 2 individuals listed in our queue with a 3rd phone number, which may be the same number as one of the individuals in our queue. That being said, I'll lead off with a Mr. Bruce Patterson.
Okay, very good. Mr. Patterson, the floor is yours.
Chairman, if you just give me a moment, I believe Robert will be working opening access to Mr. Patterson. Just give me just 1 second.
Please wait 1 second. I wasn't near my computer to enable Mr. Patterson's audio.
Okay, we'll wait. No problem.
You're now unmuted, Mr. Patterson.
Okay, Mr. Patterson, the floor is yours. Okay, Robert, can you just check to make sure that Mr. Patterson is unmuted and has the opportunity to speak if he wishes?
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yes, can hear you now.
Oh, you can't hear me?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yes, good afternoon, commissioners of the Freehold Board, and the newly minted commissioner, Leon, welcome aboard. This is Bruce Patterson of Garwood, New Jersey. Happy New Year. Yeah, it's interesting now, switching over to the word commissioner. Freeholder was an antiquated name. I don't see any problem with the removal of that, except it's probably going to cost a lot of money, of course, to change the names over in all the documentation. Plus, I think Oprah probably will be an issue too. But we'll cross that bridge as we go along. Some questions on the agenda. There's a lot of resolutions. Number 18, it's awarding a contract to Lurch Vincey Higgins for $150,000 for this year. It says, in connection, financial advisory service, in connection with special projects. I'm just wondering what these special projects will be. Mm-hmm. Continuing on, number 40, that's extending a contract with Acrisure for this year, all the way to 2022, it looks like. And I've spoken on Acrisure before, that it's Gary Taffet, and he's a disreputable person with a bad background because he had to resign as chief of staff from Governor McGreevy's office. They found that he used, during the campaign season of Greevy, he used his background to create him and another fellow, create a billboard program where they were buying billboards. And right before McGreevy came on board as governor, they sold and made a profit of $2.4 million in like 6 months. Something was unethical there. And then they found out that he was insider trading, and the SEC had to fine him $750,000. This gentleman who's part of this Acrisure down in Woodbridge, I really seriously think you should disconnect from them. Number 52, I'd say vote no on that, by the way. Number 52 is the Road Services Paratransit. Yeah, it's Paratransit representing year five of the total five-year contract and has a total amount of not to exceed $4,833,000. Just a question on that. Is that for 1 year, is $4,833,000? Is that for a total cumulative of all 5 years? Well, that's a big amount if it's only for 1 year. Number 57, reflecting a change in the name of a company as Selena Support Services. What was the original name? Simple question on that. And then the last of my questions, number 62, it's exercising a final 12-month option to extend the shared service agreement between County Union and Berkeley Heights for a certified public works manager. Yeah, I thought this was only temporary until they found a public works manager. I don't understand why this is being extended for another 12 months. They couldn't find a public works manager. And could you give me an idea of who it is that you'll be sharing with for the next year and how much that will be a month? Thank you very much, commissioners.
All right, Mr. Patterson, thank you. We will start off with number 18, and I'll ask the county manager, County Manager Oldman, to address that.
Thank you, Commissioner Sherman. And Happy New Year to everybody. For number 18, that is a not to exceed amount. The firm helped us last year with the governmental complex. So the projects are assigned as needed as they come along. It is not $150,000. It is as needed as the projects come along. And for number, I could also answer, sorry, Chairman, number 62 while I'm at it. This is a three-year contract with the Township of Berkeley Heights. It was 1 year with two options. This is adopting the second option year for the total of 3 years. The person who was doing it then and now is Director Joe Graziano, and is $30,000 a year the Township of Berkeley Heights pays the county.
Okay, very good, County Manager. Appreciate that.
Thank you, Chairman.
Good. We'll go to number 40. It was a question, and is Director Scutari on the line?
Hi, good afternoon. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hi. I don't know that there is an actual question, but I can just say that we are exercising our option to renew for 2 years. We've had AcroShore for 3 years, and this is the renewal for another 2 years. And they handle medical prescription and volunteer benefits for the county.
Okay, very good, Director, thank you. 52 and 57, Director Anderson.
Good afternoon, Happy New Year. The first for MPC, it is for 1 year, but the average amounts, it's not to exceed 4.8, but we've been spending 3.1, 3.2. So we're well below, but we, because it was our CCP, we have to put in the not to exceed the 4.8, but we have been coming below the not to exceed by a considerable amount every year.
Okay.
And for Solaris, as it is a name change from a Cornerstone Financial, it used to be SOS.
Okay. Okay, very good, Director, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Jimmy, do we have anybody else on the line that is registered to speak?
Chairman, we do have another individual by the name of Daniel Hahn.
No comments at this time.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Hahn. Appreciate that. Anyone else, Jimmy?
Chairman, there is one phone number in there, but I believe it was Mr. Bruce Patterson with the phone number ending in 51. So that would conclude any of the public participants for today's business portion of our reorganizational meeting.
Okay, so that being noted, there's no other comments. I'll formally close this portion of the meeting and ask for a motion to adopt resolutions 2021-1 through 2021-65.
So moved.
Moved by Commissioner Granados, and I see Commissioner Mudet with a second. Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly, Chairman. Commissioner Garrettson?
Yes.
Commissioner Granados?
Aye.
Commissioner Hudak?
Aye.
Commissioner Lourdes-Leon?
Aye.
Commissioner Palmieri-Mudet?
Aye.
Commissioner Staton?
Yes.
Chairman Pro Tem Kowalski? I'm not hearing a video. I will move on to Vice Chair Rebecca Williams.
Aye.
And Chairman Alexander Mirabella.
Aye.
And I'll go back to Chairman Pro Tem Kowalski.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Clerk. I abstain on 2021-21 and yes on the rest.
Chairman, you have 9 votes in the affirmative on all resolutions with the exception of resolution 2021-21, where you have 8 votes in the affirmative and 1 abstention.
Okay. All right, very good. We will move on now to commissioner remarks and comments. And I'm going to start. Commissioner Kowalski was supposed to be first, but we'll let her work through her technical issue. And we'll move to Commissioner Mouded on my screen.
Thank you, Chair. I'd just like to wish everyone in Union County a Happy New Year. Congratulations to Commissioners Gerritsen and Hudak on your re-elections and your swearing in. And congratulations to our newest commissioner, Lourdes Leon. Looking forward to working with you in this upcoming year. Another congratulations to our vice chair, Commissioner Williams, and our chair, Commissioner Mirabella. It was a pleasure working with all of you this past year in unprecedented times. And I look forward to a better 2021. So with that, I will close and wish everyone a happy Sunday. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner. We'll move to Commissioner Gerritsen.
Yes, thank you, Chairman. It was a pleasure to be able to be with everyone today during our swearing in. Not only did we all get sworn in, but it is always just a treat to have our governor there. And I'm truly grateful to him for all of his support of me through the years. The last time he swore me in, it was a pretty good 3 years. So I'm so excited that he was able to swear me in again. I also want to just note that this year, we really had a lot of diversity, equity, and inclusion issues that happened all up and down the state, our country, our world with the pandemic. And as we think about being sworn in today as commissioners and what it took to really change the name, but not just changing the name and saying it, but what it means. And every time we say freeholder versus commissioner, what that really means to so many people that a lot of people sacrifice. So I'm just so happy that we're on the other side of it. I'm looking forward to the county being able to embrace it. And I look forward to seeing more and more folks around the state. I saw there was several articles, different counties were able to really highlight the transition and what it meant to them. So it's just really something that's just one county, but it's really all 21 counties. So I'm really excited to have been a part of that movement. I also wanna recognize my great town of Hillside. I have so many amazing people who support me just incredibly. And it is just such a warm feeling to know that they are there with me through it all. And my sorority, they've really come through this year. So there is an abundance of love and support and so many people throughout the county. I just really enjoy when we get to run, you get to really talk to so many different municipalities, the leadership, the people. And it's the people that keep me going. So I just want to really embrace and thank all of those who have not found it robbery to support my growth and my ability to be able to serve 3 more additional lovely years. I'm excited about it. And I'm truly, really humbled today to be able to, again, thank everyone who came out, whether it was in person or whether you're watching electronically. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I just couldn't do it without all of you because you are why I'm here. So I thank all my colleagues, but most importantly, I thank the public for continuing to make it possible for me to be a public servant and do what I'm elected to do. So thank you and God bless and have a great day.
Thank you, Commissioner. We'll move to Commissioner Granados.
Thank you, Chair. Just want to start by wishing everybody a happy new year. And just want to thank the tremendous leadership our county commissioners have when it comes to servicing the residents of Union County. And I know we're definitely going to have a great team with Vice Chair Williams and Chairman Mirabella at the helm of our county government. So I just want to congratulate you both on a successful year that we all know that you both will have together. So with that said, let's continue our great success we have in championing for the residents of Union County. Thank you. And hold on a second. I want to give a special shout out to our winners, Angela Gerritsen, who today continues to make history, not only at Hillside, but the state of New Jersey. Commissioner Chris Hudak, who definitely is somebody who, even while gaining his law degree, continued to be at the helm of making sure that he's working for the residents of Union County, which isn't easy. And he did that with great strides and made sure that nobody even realized he was in school while he was being commissioner, because we always saw him active and present in the community. And our newest commissioner, Lourdes Leon, a great friend, somebody who I know will bring her educational background, bring her community activism, and most importantly, bring your heartfelt love for Union County to the forefront. So with that said, I wish everybody a happy new year.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Kowalski has a new, I think, microphone that works.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Whoa, progress. Thank you. Thank you, Chairman. Thanks to all of my colleagues and to the county manager, deputy county manager, and our wonderful Union County staff. Welcome to new Commissioner Leon, and congratulations to Commissioners Hudak and Garrettson as well, and our new Chair Mirabella again, and Vice Chair Williams. Just want to rededicate ourselves to doing the best that we can to overcome the issues that we face in Union County. Thanks to all our directors who have faced the pandemic with us and done the best that could be done for the residents of Union County. So looking forward to 2021. Thanks to all of you, and back to you, Chairman.
Okay, thank you very much, Commissioner Kowalski. We will move now to Commissioner Staton.
Thank you, Chair. Good afternoon and Happy New Year, everyone. As we look forward to 2021, we don't enter this year lightly. We enter with challenges and lots of hope for a new year of free from sickness and coming out this pandemic, along with erasing racism. We have challenges ahead of us throughout the world, you know? So I just pray that we have a very productive year as we did last year, helping our residents in Union County. The food insecurities, there are so many challenges ahead, but we are ready and we are prepared, especially getting the vaccines rolling. So I thank you, Union County, for standing by us and just be patient. We're doing the best that we can. And I'd like to congratulate my newly elected commissioners, Lourdes and Angela and Chris, welcome back. And everyone, please stay safe and look forward to seeing you next month. Take care. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Commissioner Staton. It sounds good now. I'm starting to get the hang of it now. It sounds really, really good. I'm going to move on now to our newest commissioner, Commissioner Leon.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to wish everyone a happy new year. I'm extremely excited and humbled. I have been welcomed with open arms at the county. This is a family group, and we're going to work very hard. I'm so happy to start this new journey. And I'm just so humbled that the voters put their trust in me. Mm-hmm. And you guys have been so welcoming, so warm. I'm truly excited. I want to wish everyone a happy new year. And I'm ready to start working. I'm ready to represent. Right. Thank you. Happy New Year, everyone.
Good. Welcome. Welcome. And that will lead us to Vice Chair Williams.
Thank you, Chairman. I'd like to echo the comments of my colleagues for this year, especially what Commissioner Staton said about the challenges that we have ahead. I also want to congratulate Commissioner Leon, my colleague Commissioner Garrettson, and also Commissioner Hudak on their election and re-election. Also, congratulations are in order for our Sheriff Pete Corvelli and our County Clerk Joanna Majapi on their re-election. I want to congratulate our Chairman for the second year in a row, El Mirabella, and I want to thank my colleagues for the trust and faith that you have given me to serve as vice chair. It is truly an honor. And I also, you know, want to applaud our county for stepping up at the very beginning of this pandemic, especially our county manager, Ed Oatman, and his staff, and deputy county manager, Amy Wagner, and all of our directors who gave their all to ensure that we committed ourselves to providing the best access to testing in the entire state. And we did it first. That's something to be proud of. And as we move forward, rolling out our vaccination program, I have great faith that we once again will do a wonderful job in serving our residents and keeping everyone safe. And I think that's about it for me, but I really do look forward to us getting back to work. I look forward to eventually us all being in person. And I know that the chairman has a number of wonderful initiatives for 2021 that you may have heard in his remarks prior to this meeting. So I'm really looking forward to 2021. Thank you all so much. And back to you, Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you, Vice Chair Williams. Very nice. And it's nice to be back at full strength with 9 commissioners. I can say this would not be penalized my quarter, former freeholder Estrada reached out to me this morning to wish me luck and wish the board luck. And of course, this is the first reorg that that then freeholder Estrada has been on in over 2 decades. And I wanted to share that with everyone. I thought it was important to note that. But it's certainly nice to be back at a full strength with 9 commissioners. And I send my congratulations as we've done. I feel like we have the right people elected at the right time with the right team to deal with this pandemic that we've been dealing with and position ourselves for the future here in Union County. And the great congratulations to Commissioners Garrettson and Hudak on their reelection and our newest freeholder, Commissioner. See, I still hold me accountable. Leon, who brings us to that full strength, she brings a nice wealth of experience from the city of Elizabeth through education and community, volunteering and outreach. I think she's going to be a real good addition to our team. And I think you said family. I think that's how I prefer to look at this group. We're in it together, we work together, and we need to rely on each other for that. So I'm really excited for our newest commissioner to join this team and to join the rest of us. I did comment to the other commissioners when Commissioner Leon was getting sworn in, I said, there's nothing like your first time getting sworn in. The re-election swearing-ins are not bad either, but the first time is special. So enjoy that, Lourdes, you deserve it, you earned it. Same with Clerk Rajapi and Sheriff Corvelli, 2 of our constitutional officers who really, are among the leaders, if not the leaders in the state, in their respective areas. I do want to thank Governor Murphy for taking time out of his schedule to be with us live in person. He could have been anywhere in the state of New Jersey, and he chose to be in Union County today, and that was terrific for us. It shows the support and the commitment from the governor's office, and we work together with his office to be there. So that was great to see him in person. The same with Senator Scutari, who leads our county, not only in the state of New Jersey in the Senate, certainly as our Democratic Party chairman, but has done a great job pulling this county together. And I complimented him before. I wasn't sure that was gonna be so easy or possible, but he certainly was able to do that. I know Freelder Hudak. I didn't forget him, Commissioner. I'm going to let you go. It's just food like there's everything. Sorry about that. I got out of order because Commissioner Kowalski's in another office and I'm going to have to find you. So I'm sorry. I'm sorry for skipping over you, Commissioner. Let me finish and I'll give Commissioner Hudak the last word. We actually were happy to lead the state of New Jersey with testing. With food distribution, and we will with vaccines. When they are ready for distribution, Union County will be the leaders for that too. And I do want to thank County Manager Oben and Deputy County Manager Wagner and all the directors for their work leading our county on the day-to-day aspect of things. I mean, we couldn't have a harder working, more dedicated group of directors, each experts in their field, leading us on behalf of this commissioner board, our direction and their execution is hand in hand, and it works very well. We have a new president on the way, so I'm very delighted on January 20th to see President Biden. It will be the end of 4 long years for counties like Union dealing with the outgoing president. I do want to thank a few people who really have been able to change on a whim, basically, how we communicate to the public, and they have done a good job, and today is no exception, to have part of it live outside, part of it inside, all the speeches that all of you delivered so well that were shown in between us getting to our PCs. And that credit goes to Jim Pelletieri, who really does a terrific job, is one of the unsung heroes here in Union County, making sure that everything is done the way we need things done. And that's no easy task. I mean, he's trying to, you know, herd 9 commissioners, his own staff, make sure everybody does what they need to do in a complex and changing environment, very difficult. Robert Charkowski is able to pull the technical pieces together very well. And with some kind of diving save, he got Commissioner Kowalski in front of a microphone that worked. So that was great as well. Dave Plumenstein, who's done a terrific job with all our speeches, and Lamar Jackson, who's not far behind him with doing video stuff and keeping everybody together and our message out there to the public. It's been a dynamic and ever-changing year, and we've kept up with that. Okay, so with extended apologies to Commissioner Hudak, I will now turn the floor over to him. Commissioner.
Thanks, Chairman. Congratulations to Commissioner Gerritsen and welcome, Commissioner Leon. Congratulations, Chairman, Vice Chairman. I'll bank the rest of my time. Happy New Year.
Thank you. Thank you, Commissioner Hudak. I'm sorry again. And I don't know that there's anything else left, but I will have asked for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Moved by Fielder Commissioner Granados and seconded by Commissioner Leon. And Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly, Chairman. Commissioner Gerritsen?
Yes, and Happy New Year.
Commissioner Granados?
Aye.
Commissioner Hudak?
Aye.
Commissioner Leon?
Aye.
Commissioner Palmieri Mudeg?
Aye.
Commissioner Staton?
Yes, and let's go Cowboys.
Whoa. Take it easy.
Chairman Pro Tem Kowalski?
Yes.
Vice Chair Williams?
Aye.
And Chairman Mirabella?
Aye. Let's go Giants.
That's 9 votes in the affirmative. We are ended.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year.